Training Module 2, EDR History. Early airbag systems all used multiple mechanical switches to deploy the airbag. Installing the Bosch CDR Tools software. Originally, the CDR software was delivered through the mail via a CD. But effective late 2010, the software delivery method was updated. It is now distributed via the internet and email. That have been superseded with new parts. In some cases, use of those outdated parts could spoil data as you're trying to collect it. So one of the purposes of the reader software will not allow you to read data from a vehicle. It will not allow you to print a CDR report. And there are other left click on Save As. It then opens a new window that gives us a chance to navigate to the very same place.
The software license holder
name appears lower left. And there's some information that appears lower right. It's probably hard to read. It says no interface. It doesn't mean anything to us right now, but it will be helpful to us in the next training module. We find ourselves at the completed training module checkmark. In this training module, we moved from concept to execution.
In the previous training module, we learned how to set up the communication ports on your computer so that the CDR software could see the interface module. First assignment, collect data from a 2009 Chevy Trailblazer. First, we check the help file to see if this vehicle is covered. Here's the result from the help file. We see that the Trailblazer is covered. We see that it's covered in NAFTA countries, which is essentially four parts from the entire CDR kit to collect data via the DLC. And here are those parts. The first part is a laptop with an activated.
We need to locate
the car's DLC port so that we can connect the free
and
end.
I get
of the
an
DLC.
Error screen, and we'll drag it up here so we can see it.
Those are both
vehicle
says,
cables, and that's consistent with the observations that we made earlier. We see power
stated
to the
another
way.
Module.
The interface module can't see the airbag control module. Well, why can that be? It turns out that this is the most common error when attempting to collect
data.
Power to the airbag control module? The answer to that question is we turn on the key. So I'm going to reach around and turn on the
key.
The screen says reading data from module. We've demonstrated our first image. This image was conducted via the vehicle's DLC. DLC images are easy. DLC
recall
earlier we saw this button, and here it is at the top. It says read VIN from vehicle. So now let's move on to assignment number 2. Collect data from a 2007 Chevrolet Avalanche. We see that the Avalanche is covered. We see that it's covered in NAFTA countries. We see that EDR number 1 is an airbag control module.
We want to read the information from the event data recorder in this vehicle today. First, I need to know what type of vehicle it is. So, and looking up the 1999 Chevrolet Cavalier, it informs me that the airbag control module is under
say,
the way.
Found that cable and brought that cable here. Now that we have the data from the module, we'll remove power to it. And that completes reading the module successfully.
And it turns out that when the automakers design these, that their biggest concern was that connectors might come unplugged during the life of the vehicle, and then the airbag says raised metal portion here, and then it's going to snap and clip. Position assurance device. And when I push this underneath the yellow tang here, it's going to make sure that I can't possibly push down on this.
Oh, no. So the trick to getting a car with a start-stop button into the run position is going to depend on the car. The way that we do it in this particular car is we're sure that the proximity key is in the car and I just lay it down.
We're here to make an electrical system assessment on this 2011 Chevrolet Aveo to determine what method to use to try to read the event data recorder. And it would appear that we have an intact fuse box. I don't see any evidence that the base of the fuse box itself is cracked.
Congratulations! You've successfully completed IPTM's online
Bosch CDR Tool Technician class.
It has been our pleasure to lead you through this online training.
If you have